Tonight, live from the rinks in Hot Park, New York, the Stony Brook University Seawolves take on the Adrian College Bulldogs in an epic ACHA battle. You're watching Seawolves Hockey Live. Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to Seawolves Hockey Live. Andy Mignani here, along with Andy Sukoff, will join me in just a little bit. Tonight, the 14-1 Stony Brook Seawolves take on the 11-1 Adrian College Bulldogs. The Seawolves come into tonight's game ranked third in the nation and moved up four spots after coming off their sweep last weekend of Liberty University. Tonight, the Seawolves will face their biggest challenge of the season as they face off against number six-ranked Adrian College. The Adrian College Bulldogs from Michigan play in the Great Lakes Collegiate Hockey League. Teams in their division include number ranked Davenport, 25 Oakland, Eastern Michigan, number 12 Michigan at Dearborn, number 24 Michigan and Kent State. The Seawolves play in the Eastern States Collegiate Hockey League, which includes number 11 Lebanon Valley College, number 19 Delaware, number 16 Rutgers, Rhode Island University, and Westchester University. Last weekend, the Seawolves swept Liberty University for the first time in the team's history. Adrian spanked Davenport 8-1, so both of these teams are playing extremely well and are well positioned to make a strong run for the ACHA championship. There's no doubt that it'll be a very entertaining weekend of hockey, so we're glad you can join us. Both of these teams are also very well coached, and I'll bring in Andy Sukoff now. Andy, you spoke with the head coach of Adrian.
I did. I spoke with Coach Hodnicki before the game. And one of the things that he said was that they want to try to, that they're trying new ways to score goals and getting those dirty goals that we've seen Stony Brook get many of this season. So they're going to try to play a very similar game to what Stony Brook does, only they have a lot of size advantage to the Seawolves.
That's right. And we're going to have some interviews between both coaches, and we'll share that with you a little bit later on. But meanwhile, the players are on the ice, and let's get to the players' spotlight as we'll talk about the Stony Brook Seawolves first. We'll go to the top scorers for the Seawolves. Number 17 is Captain JT Hall. In 13 games, JT Hall has 10 goals, 19 assists for 29 points. He has two power play goals, two shorthanded goals, 16 minutes in penalties, and has a game winner.
Good for the ninth in the ACHA in scoring.
Next up is number 74, Tyler Underhill. And Tyler, in 13 games, has 16 goals, 6 assists for 22 points. He has 6 power play goals, and he has 10 minutes in penalties and 3 game winners. And finally, number 90, Andrew Satola, in 14 games for the Seawolves. Andrew has 5 goals, 16 assists for 21 points. He's got a couple of power play goals, 24 minutes in penalties, and a game winner as well. Tonight in nets for the Seawolves will be number 33, Derek Wilms, and in 6 games, Derek is 6-0. He's got a 2.21 goals against average and presently a .920 save percentage. He'll be backed up by Scarola, Todd Scarola, number 32, and Scarola in 6 games has 6 wins with a 2.12 and a .921 save percentage. So that's the tick of the tail of the Seawolves. We're going to switch it over to Andy. Andy, take it away for the Adrian Bulldogs.
All right, we're going to start with the top scorer for Adrian, Brad Coburn, number 27. Guy has 18 goals, 12 assists, which is good for 6th in the ACHA in total points. Then going from there, you have your 1 and 1A goalies. You don't even need to talk about the rest of your goal scorers. First, number 56, Austin Rodebush. In 6 games, he's 6-0-0 with a 1.33 goals against, a .947 save percentage, and 2 shutouts. And then the 1A, number 1, Matthew Schnoes. In 5 games, he's 4-1 with a 1.40 goals against, a .923 save percentage, and 1 shutout. So if you're the Seawolves, you score against these guys, keep the puck.
Yeah, and they also got a couple other guys that score pretty well, too, in Tyler Duarte. And he's in 11 games, has 7 goals for 12 assists for 19 points. A couple of power play goals. He's got 2 minutes in penalties and a game winner. And also number 12, Ted Anstett, in 8 games, has 6 goals, 9 assists for 15 points. And that's pretty good for someone who's only played eight games. So there's another kid that can score the score and set some plays up. He has 4 minutes and penalties, and he's got a game winner as well. So this is going to be an incredible matchup tonight. You got number six, Adrian, who was actually number four a week or two ago. They've moved back to six. They play in a tough division in the Michigan League. And the Seawolves have moved from seventh to third on a couple of great wins last weekend, of course. Liberty's having their worries this year. They're not as strong as they were in previous years, but they played at that brand new facility. Coach Garofalo will talk a little bit about it when we share the interview with you folks. But we're getting toward the end of the warm-up, and before we get through it, it was kind of interesting to talk to the head coach a little bit from Adrian. They drove up, or drove across, actually, on Thursday evening, and you know, we have to, you know, take a minute to say something about the incident that happened in Paris. And it's interesting because they had brought the boys downtown Manhattan and dropped them off to go see Times Square and down to the memorial site when the incident started to occur. So they immediately grabbed the guys, put them back on the bus, and brought them back to the hotel because of that tragedy that happened in Paris. So they didn't even really get a chance to enjoy it, but it was a very surreal moment for them who were down at the World Trade Center Monument Memorial to actually hear that news happening while they were down there.
Yeah, I mean, I was watching CNN, and you see every update, just more people injured, more dead. It's unbelievable that something like that could happen to a great city such as Paris. So we throw our support to the French people, the people of Paris, and hope that they come out of it.
Yep, and we can only wish for the best for them and the families who've lost family members, brothers, sisters, so on and so forth. And our hearts are with you, Paris. All right, so we're going to take a break, and we'll be back in a few minutes. But we're going to be actually showing you a couple of interviews that we had pre-recorded with both of the coaches. And the first one up will be with Coach Chris Garofalo, and we'll be showing you that now. This is Danny Bignani. I'm here with Coach Chris Garofalo from the Stony Brook Seawolves. Chris, talk to us a little about last weekend against Liberty.
Like I said, the environment was unreal. I mean, it's a D1 ready program. I mean, their rink, they renovated it, 3,000 seats, they had 3,000 fans. They got a great supporting, you know, staff down there. The fans are unreal. But our guys were ready. I mean, we were really excited to play, and to take two from them was huge for us.
I noticed that you had said earlier that this was going to be a big challenge for your team and that you'd never really swept Liberty. So how does the team feel after that?
You know, I've been with the program for 20 years, and this is the first time we've ever swept Liberty. And I think it does speak volume about the direction our program is going in and has been going in, and talks about how these guys, you know, with their hard work, it pays off, and it paid off last weekend.
Tonight you got a big challenge facing a number six team in the country. And Adrian, what can you tell us?
Well, they're fast, they're strong, they're deep. They're a top-ranked team in the country. This is our biggest challenge. Last weekend was big for us. This is the biggest challenge to date for us as an organization. I mean, you know, if the guys play with the same tenacity and same effort, I feel good about tonight. But Adrian, you know, they're top-shelf organization. They've every year they do very well. So I'm really excited for it. I'm really excited for the guys to see, you know, to play a really competitive game and see what they do.
Awesome. This is going to be an awesome week of hockey. You can all tune in and watch the Stony Brook Seawolves facing Adrian. Thank you very much, Coach Garofalo.
Thanks, Andy. Thank you.
All right, we're going to segue over to Andy Sukhoff with Coach Hopnicki.
I'm down ringside with Rob Hopnicki, head coach of the Adrian College Bulldogs. Coach, your team is on a 6-8 winning streak. You're 10-1 on the season. What do you attribute your biggest success for this so far?
We're getting pretty consistent goal scoring out of our top players. We're doing a good job playing defensively, and lately our depth has really helped our overall scoring. I think we've scored 7 or 8 goals in our last 6 games, so it's been a pretty our depth has really shown, and scoring has been a big part of that.
Yeah, I was looking at some of the stats in preparation for this game, and your power play is one of the best I've seen in the ACHA, and that's got to go a long way for your team.
Yeah, we've been pretty successful. We've been getting pucks to the net, doing a good job of creating plays off of the odd man opportunities we've had. But Overall, we're trying to score goals differently. Our in nationals lately, we found out that our gameplay has to change, so we've been trying to get a little dirtier with the goals and get the goals from rebounds and things in the crease.
And speaking of the crease, your goalie plays one of the best in the ACHA. You have the number 4 and number 5 goalie in the league. That's got to be a great knowing for you as a coach that you have that assurance there.
Yeah, it's been great. They've both been great this year. They were great last year for us, and having them a year older, they've just continued to develop. And it's a great luxury to know that you can throw either one of them in net, and in the end of it, they're going to get a good performance between the pipes.
And talking about tonight's game, what's your game plan going into a game against the Seawolves team that's won 8 straight so far?
Try to play them physical. We watched some tape. We saw they have tremendous skill, tremendous speed, so we have to match that. And then hopefully if we can play physical, we'll be able to get some dirty goals. And I think that'll probably be the difference in the weekend. So.
All right. Thank you, Coach.
Thank you very much.
You're watching Seawolves Hockey Live.
All right, folks. As warm-ups are coming to an end right now, we're going to take our break, and we'll be back for the start of the first period. Thanks for tuning in and watching Seawolves Hockey Live. Hey, welcome back to Seawolves Hockey Live, everyone. And first thing we want to do is apologize about our signal. We have nothing to do with that. That's the rinks here, and the signal coming out to the internet is very poor. So this game will be uploaded to be viewed in its full entirety in better quality later in the week. So here's the starting lineup for the Stony Brook Seawolves. Number 11 is right wing Eddie Ososki. And centering that line is number 13, Crockett. And on left wing, number 21, Bozer. Starting on defense, left defense will be Michael Cartwright, number 24. And on right defense, Frank Kasha. In net for the Seawolves will be number 33, Derek Wilms. As far as Adrian is concerned, they will start with center, number 18, Schwier. Right wing, Baudet, number 19, Polishek. On defense, it'll be Gettle, and number 26, Alden. In net will be Rosebush. Backing him up will be Schnooze. And the announcements are on the ice going on right now, but we want to give you the starting lineup, so we'll take a quick break before the start, and we'll be back for the drop of the puck. And welcome back to Seawolves Hockey Live, folks, as we get ready for the start of the Stony Brook Seawolves versus the Adrian Bulldogs. Folks, again, we're going to apologize profusely for the internet signal coming out. It's going to stutter and stammer. Unfortunately, there's nothing much we can do about it. It's the signal that's coming out of the rink itself. Again, we will be updating this game so you can watch it in its entirety up on YouTube later in the week. So keep an eye out for that. Meanwhile, we're going to get started as both teams are making their way to the center ice area where Pincus, our head referee, will drop the puck. We got Rubin as one linesman and Seltzer's the other. And Pincus is calling both centermen to the center ice dot. Schwier will co-center for Adrian and Crockett for the Seawolves. Folks, as we get ready to get underway, you're watching Seawolves Hockey Live. Face-off one back by Adrian. Through the neutral zone. And big hit by Crockett on Polishek. Around the boards to Bozer. Bozer's pinched in on right away. Pace of this game is already quick. Shot right on, saved by Wilms. Shot from the point. Came from Polishek and gobbled up by Wilms. Face-off in the Seawolves zone to the left of Wilms. On the draw again, it'll be Crockett. Up against Schwier. And this time Crockett wins the draw back to Cartwright. Cartwright around the wall to Kosher, misses the pass. and trying to get it up the wall. Steeples having a little difficulty getting out. Now over to Bozer. Bozer will just try to tap it out, get it out of the zone. Dump back into the Steeples zone as Adrian goes for a line change. Steeples trying to catch him. He'll dump it in. Chase after it as they go for a change as well. This is Ososki with a big hit in the corner on Alden. Back to Ososki on the forecheck for the Seawolves as he goes against McLean. Back behind the net to Ososki, looking for opportunity for JT Hall, who's now on the ice. Gilbert trying to keep in, and back out to neutral zone, picked up by Schurting.
Bozer was calling for that puck. He was staying right in the slot, right in front of Roterbush, and Ososki wasn't able to get the puck to him. But this is a game here where it's going to be very physical, so Seawolves are going to have to use their speed to match up with that well.
And that pass goes awry, and it'll be icing on the Seawolves. Gilbert trying to get it to Hall and unable to tap it with his stick. Back in the Seawolves zone, faceoff will be to the right of Wilms. And on the draw for Adrian,
and Andy, this series is incredibly
it'll be number 9, McLean, going up against Hall. And faceoff stalemate picked up by Adrian, fired to the corner. Back behind the net, McLean battles against Gilbert. For the Seawolves, picked up by number 12, that's Atstedt, out to the point. There's a shot, and it never got to the net. Deflected off of Captain Hall into the corner. And now Adrian controlling the puck in the Seawolves zone. Picked up by Hall, he's bumped hard. He got a big check there. Now through the neutral zone comes Underhill. Underhill's got trailer with him and could not get it to Lizaldi. Puck comes out to the neutral zone, picked up by Schurting. He'll just fire in, and the Seawolves will have to go for a change.
Underhill was trying to go one-on-one with McKinnon, and McKinnon at 6'5", he's got a wingspan that Underhill just couldn't get past.
Satola back to DeFeo, trying to get to the net to save the first shot on goal for the Seawolves as that puck was gobbled up by Roterbush. Roterbush. We'll get his name right.
Roterbush coming into this game with a .947 save percentage like we spoke about in the pregame. And what Coach Hadnicki was saying, that having them back for another year and a year more experience has been a great boost to his team's success.
All right, faceoff won by Adrian up to the neutral zone and dumped in the Seawolves zone. Back to get it is Heffernan for the Seawolves. He fires around the wall trying to get Colillo. Colillo bangs it out, and now it's dumped right back in cross corner by Duarte. Picked up by Miller. Miller's got plenty of ice room to get through the neutral zone. Colillo trying to tap it through, but standing up on the blue line is Adrian and not allowing the Seawolves entry into their zone. Back to the neutral zone, picked up, dropped off by Colillo. Colillo gets it into the zone as Satola trying to get a hold of it. Adrian doing a good job bottling up the Seawolves. Now it's turned over to Feo. He loses it and picked up by McKay as he'll get it across. And back out into the neutral zone comes Adrian. He'll just dump and change. Coming in on the forecheck is McKay against Heffernan. Wilms took a spill, but the puck comes up to DeFeo. Now DeFeo just hoists it. And these are the plays that Stonerbrook got to be careful not to grip their sticks too tightly on. You have plenty of time and space there for DeFeo to get that puck moved. And now it's a faceoff going to be in the zone.
And this is a game where the Seawolves cannot make a mistake. They have to complete every pass.
It's like Coach Garofalo said. There's going to be mistakes made in this game. It's going to be how you capitalize on their mistakes and how you come back from your mistakes. But there will be mistakes made in this game because the pressure between both teams is high right now. Faceoff won by the Seawolves. And Stemke now is the fourth line for the Seawolves has made that onto the ice. This is Stemke, and he loses control. They're going to have a first penalty of the game here, as number 24 for Adrian is going to go to the box. That's Justin Fisher, who will go for tripping, it looks like.
You're going to call for the hook.
Yeah, actually a hook.
Yeah, so Fisher coming into this game had 8 penalty minutes.
We'll watch the faceoff will be inside the Adrian zone.
And this is a big opportunity here for the Seawolves. Get a power play goal early on. Get Adrian back on their heels.
Yeah, get some momentum. Yeah, and if anything, get some momentum. Even if you don't score, try to change the table here because the table right now is tilted. All right, back into the Seawolves zone, back behind the net. Wilms will get it back to Schurting, who will get it over to Cartwright. And Cartwright will start out. And we'll look at how Adrian defends on the PK. That pass was going to go into the corner, not so easily there. McKinnon, 6'5", just gloved it down and shot it right down the ice. Seawolves have to be aware of his size and wingspan.
And he's not the only one with size. There's There's 14 players on the Adrian College team that are 6 foot and over, including 6 of 8 defensemen, many of whom are 6'2 and 6'3.
Vasali now trying to get it to the point, but now he's being watched by two Adrian players. This is JT Hall. JT Hall with some time and space now. Gets it over to Schurting. Fires! And it was knocked down in front. Never got to the net. Schurting picks it back up. Throws it to the net. Save. Here comes Underhill. He shoots. Fires! Save made! Back up the wall and out into the neutral zone. Siegel's putting some pressure on.
Yeah, they're putting some good pressure on Roderbush. Roderbush stepping up, though, and living up to that 947 tape.
JT Hall was just hammered to the wall by 26. Now Siegel's controlling the puck. Back to Schurting. Schurting fakes the shot. Now over to Kasha. Shoots! And it was off the glove of Roderbush. Down low behind the net is Crockett. Crockett back over to Wasoski. Into the corner. Lost it. Picked up by, back to the point, to Schurting, wide, fires, oh, and just missed wide on the short side. Picked up by the Seawolves, back to Schurting at the point. He's got Kasha. Kasha's going to get it back to Schurting. Schurting, walk it in, shoots, it blocked. Good block there by number 28, Baudette, down low. Satola back across to Schurting. Schurting, wait up, trying to get that shot, another shot, rebound, saved by Roderbush. Drew a screen.
And Roderbush didn't really see it. He sprawled out and kicked it out with his right pad. So
Seawolves coming hard, putting lots of pressure on here in the penalty kill. Now we're all even up.
And that was a very good power play.
If anything, it shifted some momentum. Now the Seawolves just got to be careful not to give that all back, because now the ice is tilting in the other direction. This is go all the way down, and no icing here. Pretty surprising there was no icing called. Good play here by Bishop on that turnaround, get that puck out of the zone, as Adrian's going to try to come back now and grab some of that momentum they had earlier. Stemke in on the forecheck, as well as Boudreau, who's out for his first shift. Bishop throws it to the net, stick to the corner by Roderbush. And here comes Adrian out through the neutral zone. And we got an offside play. Down at the 13:51 in the first period. There's no score here. Right now, Stony Brook out shooting Adrian 5-1. That had a lot to do with that power play. And the faceoff will be in the neutral zone. Satola on the draw against Fisher. And Satola loses it. Picked up by Adrian. And that was Bolavich with a shot on goal and a glove down by Wilms. Faceoff in the Seawolves zone. Be Satola for the Seawolves, and he'll go against Fisher. Loose puck, and picked up by Adrian. Adrian's winning some of these defensive draws in the Seawolves zone.
They have to improve on that and get control of the faceoff on the outset to push the puck out and get the play back in the offensive zone.
Now Miller hoists it out. Coming through the neutral zone is Kalilla, but he's matched right away. And now fired back into the zone, picked up by number 10, Peters, fires it around to his defensive partner, Hoskin. Quick pass to the neutral zone. All the way wide to Fisher as they go for a change. Fisher throws it on goal, saved by Wilms.
Wilms coming up big in the onset.
Shot off the side of the net, and Wilms will sit on it and freeze the puck here.
Smart play there by Wilms as it rings off the post, rolls back to him. He smartly just hangs on to it, gets the whistle, and gives the Seawolves a chance to change. This first period has been a lot of back and forth. We saw the Seawolves have the early part of the first 5 minutes, and now we're seeing Adrian kind of take some kind of control here in the last few minutes.
Yeah, I mean, Adrian, I thought, had the advantage in the first couple of minutes until they took the penalty. Then the Seawolves took the momentum back. Now Adrian's slowly but surely climbing back with some momentum. Seawolves need to keep their feet moving. Puck is out, not out of the zone. Cartwright trying to get it off the glass. Now to Hall through the neutral zone. Hall breaking in. Oh, and ahead of the play was Lazaldi. Speaking of Lazaldi, we had the pleasure of meeting Mr. Lazaldi and Mr. Lazaldi Sr., the grandfather and the father, and they both said very nice, kind words about the program here.
Very, very nice people they are.
Yeah. So they're in from California for a couple days, and getting used to the cold weather here on the East Coast. Like we got one day of it, it's today.
Yeah, they picked a good weekend to come. At least there's no rain.
All right, picked up by Lazaldi. Coming through the neutral zone. Nice move through the neutral zone. Spins and moves. Fires in and chases after his pass. Lazaldi in on a forecheck against Godel. Back to the point, trying to keep it in his caution. He does off the back of the referee, but yeah, wouldn't be the first time Pink has caught a puck off his rear end.
I feel like there's a good story involved with that.
Yeah. Back to the neutral zone, picked up by Underhill, who just fires in. And through the neutral zone comes Adrian. This is Alden, who gets hammered by Underhill. And trying to get the puck. Folks, this is a really tough hitting game right now.
Yeah, this game is
going
to be
some really stuff going on behind the scenes here. This is two teams you know that are in for the battle.
Yeah, these are two high-ranking teams.
Here's Crockett. Fires a shot right on goal. Saved by Roundebush.
Oh. Like I was saying, these are two very high-ranked teams. Stony Brook at number three. Adrian number six. This is a series that can really dictate positioning later on, assuming that both teams win out the rest of the way. So these are two games that both teams really want and really need.
All right. New neutral zone. Big hit by Beaudet on Schoening. It was all about leverage there. This is going to be an icing as Schoening was not in the right position there, and Beaudet just steamrolled him. Faceoff back in the Seawolves zone. It'll be to the left of Wilms on the draw. For Adrian will be Schwier, and he'll go against Crockett as these two lines match back up again. One by Adrian, back to the point, now back down low. Schwier chasing down. He's checked off by Crockett in the corner. Gilbert, Schwier now with Crockett going hard behind the net. Crockett battling hard, going to get it now is Schoening as he has Bozer breaking. Up the wall to Bozer, off. Oh.
It looks to skip over the stick.
Something must have happened there. I don't know if it hit a stick. It
hit something because Bozer was able to negate the icing. That was a smart play to get the stick right out in front, make sure that it wasn't going to be an icing because that line had been out there for quite a while.
Nice play by Ososki to get that puck in the zone, and now he's pushed off the puck, and we got a 2-on-2 coming down. This is defenseman and Gotell. Beaudet with the shot. Deep on the forecheck is McKinnon. 6'5", 210.
And that's probably a smart play for him to be.
Taken out of the play by Schoening.
A guy that size is, you know, he may not be the best skater, but
shot right on goal and saved by Wilms. Good shift by Adrian. As the defenseman, McKinnon came in and played some tough D in the offensive zone.
Yeah, and Gettle was also playing some very strong forecheck. He comes into this game, 2 goals, 2 assists, including a power play goal, as part of his very strong unit for Adrian. So that's something that the Seawolves have to watch out for.
McLean on the draw against Satola. One's another one. And again, these are the faceoffs that Seawolves want to win. They want to win those draws in your own zone. And this is flipped cross corner by DeFeo, coming hard to Satola. He loses an edge. Comes off, trying to keep that puck in. And luckily for the Seawolves, it would have been a 2-on-1 as Kasha was the only one back.
Yeah, Cartwright smartly gets on top of that puck.
Stola's trying to put his effort into this game. He's putting his body in the game and putting a good strong effort in.
And that's what all the Seawolves have to do because Adrian's a big team. And
up the wall. Kalilo 2-on-1 now. Kalilo with the fail. Kalilo shoots. Save. I don't know if it got through. It might have been blocked.
Well, it got through. It looked like it hit off Rodebush's right pad.
Yeah, maybe he got his pad, but that's the idea. You want to get that 2-on-1 and maybe be able to get that pass across. Whoop. Kasha with an ill-advised move there. Shot and a save. Kasha's trying to make moves around a team that is ranked sixth in the nation. I think you got to reconsider those types of plays.
Those are moves that might work against Syracuse or Rutgers, but it's not going to work against Adrian.
Not going to happen against a team like Adrian.
There's a reason why Adrian is 10-1 on a 6-game winning streak and crushed Davenport, because they're not going to fall for moves like that. It's a game of hit or be hit. And you gotta make the simple plays in a game like this.
Keep it simple, exactly. Face off to the right of Wilms. On the draw is Gervaisi going up against Fisher. And another win by Adrian on the draw. But Seawolves get control of it. Back to Miller. And Stemke gets it out into the neutral zone. Chasing hard. Was Boudreau, but couldn't get to it. Now Gervaisi squeezed against the wall. A lot of hitting here. This is kind of like what Coach Hobnicki said in your interview with him talking about using the size and some physicality to slow the Stony Brook down, but the Seawolves are still maintaining that speed and keeping that speed going. This is Boudreau now, sends it back behind the wall to Gervaisi. Good work here by the fourth line for the Seawolves. As the puck's controlled by Gervaisi, he throws it back to Stemke. Stemke working it hard. Boudreau now picks it up. And Boudreau's tossed down to the ice.
He's just thrown down like a regular.
Back to the point, we got a hand pass in the offensive zone.
Ladies and gentlemen, make sure to stop by the merchandise. Nice move by Boudreau there to try to protect the puck. But Balovich is just much bigger than he is, and he just kind of shoved him down.
Gettle kept pushing on Boudreau while he was down, and I don't think Boudreau really cared for that too much.
I can't say I blame him, but if somebody's pushing me while I'm down, I'd be pretty annoyed too.
All right, JT Hall with Underhill and Lizaldi. And we were talking early about Justin Lizaldi's parents are here. Oh, there's a trip. No call. We're going to have a call.
They got it.
And
they're very emphatic on the tripping call there by Pincus.
Like Pincus said, that little action, that little energy, that little, what do you call that? That accent.
Chop block.
Tripping. Okay. Adrian in the box for the second time. Seawolves going on their second power play. 0-for-1 so far. Face off to the left of Radebush. And that's Hall back. Wins that draw. Back to Schurting. Back to Cartwright at the point. Down low to Underhill. And we're watching how they're playing in a diamond right now, and then they move it to an inverted box, then they move to the straight.
And they're throwing a lot of different defensive looks at the Seawolves, and that's
back to the point to Cartwright. Schurting trying to get it to Lizaldi, but it's just not where it needed to be. Pick up to the point, and Schurting fires it, and it was deflected into the netting.
And with Adrian throwing these different looks out at him, the Seawolves can't get any kind of clear shots, so they're forcing the Seawolves to make that extra pass, and then readjusting the defensive scheme to get around to that open man, and it's going to force Seawolves to again have to keep going around the perimeter, and they're not going to get any kind of quality shots.
The penalty was on McKay, tripping for 2 minutes. All right, Lizaldi controls it back to Schurting. Schurting tries to get a shot, and a deflection from Hall. Goes high up into the rink, but nothing, it didn't hit the ceiling or the netting. This is Underhill getting it to the point to Schurting, and he misses it. Now here's a 2-on-2. Oh, that Adrian was offsides as
Polishuk got ahead of the play as Baudette was driving.
Baudette was driving, but he saw immediate resistance and he was riding the blue line. And
Polishuk just got a little over-anxious.
Yeah, so the Seawolves will now change up that power play line, and they'll come out with Crockett, DeFeo, Ososki. They'll have Kasha and on defense along with going to be 4 forwards and 1 defenseman. So
that might be what the Seawolves have to do, get that extra scoring presence out there.
And this is going to be a nice...
They called it icing, but Rodebush was going to play the puck as Crockett was coming on.
Yeah.
So that should have been...
It's going to be a center ice faceoff because of what he did. Well, he's telling him... Yeah. Yeah, center ice will be the face-off. They waved the icing off because the goaltender played the puck.
That's just a bad break for the Seawolves. They're lucky that they don't have to take the face-off down in their own zone. But that was a play that Crockett was making headway on. Rodebush comes out to play the puck so that Crockett doesn't get it. They blew the whistle a little prematurely, anticipating the icing.
All right, Satola on the draw for the Seawolves, and he'll go up against Duarte. Duarte. That's how you say it, Duarte. All right, that's going to hit the lighting and the rafters, and that'll be another face-off.
And we're about midway through this power play here, and the Seawolves have gotten 1 shot on goal here on this power play. A much different look from the previous power play where they got 4 shots on goal, and all of them were quality chances.
And Ososki just got played pretty heavily there by the 6-5. Oh, Satola just missed it. It would have been a 2-on-1, unfortunately. But McKinnon took down Ososki in center ice. Ososki was not happy about that, but you got to keep you aware. Good pass to Satola coming down on left wing. Satola, still 28 seconds left to go in the man advantage. Seawolves trying to get one on the board. DeFeo back to DeFeo, controls it to winds and fires, and it ping ponged. It did not get to the net. They need to get a hard shot, get Kasha to shoot that puck. Here's Kasha now. Kasha over to DeFeo. DeFeo sends a wrist shot, and it's blocked.
It's walked in front by Fisher.
Adrian doing a good job in the passing and shooting lanes. As we are all even up now, Seawolves unable to get much done on that power play.
Yeah, the Bulldogs are really blocking all the passing lanes, not letting the Seawolves kind of get anything going. So this might be a game where they just have to kind of drive in and push the Bulldogs out of the way and just get to the net.
Hit that by Underhill over to JT Hall, breaking in. Underhill comes in, fakes, shoots. And a block by the D, doing a lot of that blocking. Coming down left wing, it's number 12, it's Anstett. And a deflection, oh, and it's in the net. Oh, a beautiful pass and deflection. Going to watch that on a replay. Yeah, perfect setup. No, you got to always be aware of the guy who doesn't have the puck. And that's one of the conversations I have with Coach Garofalo. Let's watch this.
Here, watch it here. Here comes Anthony. He drives in. And here comes the pass.
It's all it is. It's a tap pass.
And puts off Gilbert. And that goal should get credit to Coburn. That's his 19th of the season.
Was it off Gilbert or was it off? Let's see if we can go back and look at that again. I thought that did hit a stick. I could be wrong, but if it did hit Gilbert, then it's no fault of Wilms on that one, because a deflection is a goal. That and that puck bounces right on net. So Adrian jumps out to the 1-0 lead.
Anstett will get an assist.
And we'll watch it again. Colburn figures he's the leading scorer. Now he just gets his stick down in the right spot, makes the deflection.
So those deflections that was something that Coach Hodnicki was talking about before the game. Get those dirty goals and get those goals that are right in front. And you just watch Coburn, he just muscled his way through the defense.
As Coach Garofalo said, he knows how to get to the open ice, and in that particular spot, he put the jets on right when he needed to, and all it took was a pass, a hard pass that he could deflect. And Wilms really couldn't do much with it. So
yeah, that was in an angle where you can't really do anything with it. And you gotta give credit to Coburn for finding that spot on the ice and getting there in front.
Seawolves have to wake up. They have to be careful with their when they're going to make their passes to get going and get out of the way. Miller just took a big shot on the boards, and he could have totally avoided that with just a spin move. And
Azowski's getting taking his fair share of licks as well.
And they're trying to do is intimidate the Seawolves with their size. And there's another trip, another knockdown, and not called. So we'll get to see how things progress here. And Azowski should have looked up at the point. He had Heffernan wide open, and maybe got a chance to get some open ice there. And we got a change going on. Everybody's changing.
In a game like this, both teams have to keep their heads up, especially the Seawolves, because these passes aren't connecting, so they have to look for the open man.
And Heffernan's got to make that pass a more secure pass. Going all the way across the ice through the neutral zone is very dangerous.
Yeah,
because they'll bait you. They'll totally bait you.
And we've seen them try that in other games, and it hasn't worked in other games as well. Like we saw it during one of the games against the Navy couple weeks ago, where they were trying those passes through the neutral zone and it wasn't working.
Now we'll have to see how the Seawolves can keep bringing their game and maintaining their character, not getting caught up in any kind of shenanigans, and just trying to get pucks to the net. Oh, there's a shot right on through the legs of Schurting and gobbled up by Wilms.
Wilms starting to see a lot more firepower.
There's more
here.
Jump in Adrian's steps tonight than the Seawolves right now, and I noticed that even in warm-ups.
We were talking about that in warm-ups, where it looked like Adrian was had a bit more pep as they were going through, and that's something the Seawolves have to shake off. Maybe it's just being back at home for the first time in 2 weeks, or coming off the big win against Liberty. They got to come down from that and be like, hey, we have a very important game going on right now.
Stony Brook has to push back just a bit. Take their advantage and make their hits too, and that's what they need to do. We're going to have a penalty now on the Seawolves, and it's a slash. And this is what we talked about, the composure aspect. Seawolves have to maintain that composure, not go on the PK, being down 1-0. So Satola is in the box for two for slashing. You know, you're going to get hit in this game. You got to be ready. Just don't retaliate. You'll get your chance to hit back. Faceoff to the right of Wilms as the Stony Brook Seawolves will have to kill 2 minutes. It's controlled by Adrian. Back up to the point to Rakes. Rakes down low to Dwart. Down to Rakes over to Alden. Alden down low. Back in the slot area. Everyone's keeping an eye on Coburn. Back to the point to Alden. The shot. Coburn's loose. And he scores. He's left alone down low, and he puts the puck in.
And for Coburn, that's going to be his 20th goal of the season, his fifth power play goal.
He has a relentless approach at the net. And unless you really get underneath him, you're not going to stop him.
And we're going to watch it again. And Coburn just, he's just fighting there. He just pokes it past Cartwright.
Seawolves down 2-0 in the first period. And right now, it looks like Adrian has the advantage. Not only on the scoreboard, but also in the play. So the Seawolves got to find themselves here real quickly, or otherwise this is going to get ugly fast. And in the Stony Brook, Bowser are back to get it for the Stony Brook Seawolves. In the offensive zone now. Battling down low. Osowski throws a shoulder. Bowser trying to move it, but Soski comes off the wall. He loses it. Back to the neutral zone. Tic-tac-toe play by Adrian. Baudette makes a nice move. Comes around. Oh, and another goal. This is timeout territory for the Seawolves.
Yeah, they need to reset, get it back into neutral.
Yep, this is timeout territory. Adrian is flying right now. They're feeling it. And right now, Wilms is not getting any help, and that was a bad one that he let up, unfortunately.
That's one of those that, and you see it as he knows that puck is behind him, he knows he should have stopped that one. Should be Schwer getting that goal.
Face off. Seawolves down 3-0. And need to find a goal quick. Right now, Adrian is just having their way. This is 22. Johnson coming in. We haven't even seen him in this game until now. Maybe we missed him, but back to the point. Fired down low behind the net. Cartwright trips it to the corner. Picked up by DeFeo, who just chips it out of the zone. That's two power play goals for Adrian on two attempts. And fired right on net, and that's going to be gobbled up all day long by Radebush. So we're getting down to the last 2 minutes of this first period. Right now, the Seawolves being outshot 15-10 and losing 3-0 at this time. Stick around for the end of the first period. Andy Seacoff will have a few words from Coach Garofola. Seawolves trying to find something here. Adrian doing a good job moving that puck out. And Bishop, unable to stop the defender coming in. Back to the point, shot, stick to the corner by Wilms. Bishop trying to move the puck. It has little or no room. DeFeo picks it up and he's squeezed. Now here comes Bishop coming in a left wing by himself. And his shot is deflected up off the back wall. Galillo. Seawolves have to try to get the pucks to the point. The pointmans are open. DeFeo needs to stay with his man here as it's a 2-on-1 coming in. Shot and saved by Wilms to the corner. Up. And DeFeo just jumps it into the corner, trying to get off the ice. Picked up by Underhill through the neutral zone. JT Hall and Underhill. Hall with the puck. Down to Underhill. Break it to the net. Underhill in. He shot and it didn't get to the net. He was tripped up. No call made. JT Hall with the puck. Trying to get it to the point, but it was picked off. Now he's got it back. Lizaldi's got Underhill. He had Underhill alone in front of the net and chose to pass it back to Hall. Back to the point. Saved by, kept in by Scherning. His shot gets deflected. Seawolves desperately trying to get something to the net. Back to the point to Scherning. He winds, he fires, and it's knocked down by the defense. Well, we have a potential 2-on-1 here. Heffernan coming. Oh, nice play by Heffernan. Good defensive play here.
Smart play by Heffernan. Get that puck out of there at the end of the period.
And it's going to be end of the first period. The Seawolves down by the score of 3-0. Getting outshot 15-12 by Adrian. And it's true what they said. It's going to be a tough game, and we can see it already. So we're going to kick it down to Andy Sukoff, who will have Coach Garofalo. Andy, take it away.
All right, I'm down here with Coach Garofalo. Coach, you've got 12 shots on goal, but they seem to have blocked just as many. What kind of adjustments do you have to make in the second period to get around that?
Listen, we have to score on a power play. We had 2 power play chances. Got to get at least one of those in. The game's a lot different. We also have to get pucks deep and keep doing that. Stop turning over at the blue lines. And we have to have men back. I mean, we have
move the mic closer.
Too many odd man rushes. Thank God the D made some nice plays. At the end of the day, this is a good team we're playing against, and we have to step our game up right now. It's really a test for us right now. That's what this is.
Yeah, and this team is big. They're hitting you very hard. What are you trying to do to get around the physical play?
You chip it deep and you go to work. Our speed is our biggest attribute. That's what we got to use. They're big. They can hit, but if they can't catch you, they can't hit you.
All right, thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Back to you guys.
Andy, thanks very much. Folks, we're going to take our break between periods. If you're watching Seawolves Hockey Live, we'll be back for the start of the second period. Welcome back to Seawolves Hockey Live. Everyone, Andy Mignani along with Andy Sukoff, Trevor on the controls. As Andy, we are in between periods, about another minute or so to go before the teams hit the ice. Why don't we talk about the stats for that first period?
Yeah, really, that first period, especially the latter half of the period, was all Adrian. 3-0 they lead right now. 15-12 shots on goal in favor of Adrian. The first 2 goals scored by number 27, Brad Coburn, his 19th and 20th of the season. The first assisted by Ansett and McLean. And then about 2.5 minutes later, Coburn again from Alden and McLean. And then 30 seconds after that, Polishuk scores his first from Beaudet, his 7th assist. And that's where you get your 3-0 score. You have 3 penalties, 2 for Adrian. The first one to Justin Fisher for hooking about 3.5 minutes in. And then about 12.5 minutes in, McKay goes off for tripping for Adrian. Stonerbrook unable to convert. And then the total goes off for the Seagulls for slashing, and that's where Coburn scored his 2nd goal, being a power play goal.
All right. You look at the scoreboard and you see 3-0, you see shots on goal, 15-12. You say, well, you know, Seagulls got some shots, but the shots were not of any kind of caliber. Maybe one good save, quality save, Rutabush had to make in that first period. And on the power play, yeah, really.
Adrian's also blocking a lot of shots.
They are.
I think they blocked as many shots as got on goal.
And I heard your interview with Coach Garofalo, and I agree with you. There were many blocked shots, which tends to say, okay, we're shooting with our heads down. We're not seeing what's out in front of us, and we need to start moving the puck laterally first. Let's go a little east-west before we go north-south.
Yeah, again, but what we're seeing with Adrian is they're throwing so many different defensive looks that those passing lanes are also getting blocked very quickly. And now we're in the second period where we've seen, especially here at home, the Seawolves have a lot of struggles in the second period.
Yeah, I mean,
they have to get past that, and they have to score first and second in the second period. They need to get this back to within a 1-goal game and put Adrian back. Here's the 3rd goal here. And here's the initial shot of the stick of Beaudet. And then it's going to be poked in by
It was
Polishuk.
Right through the pads of Wilms. And again.
Yeah. And you just want, that's a defensive last hit that they let not one, not two, but 3 players get into the defense and get past them.
Wilms had, you know, made a couple of nice saves in that period, kept the Seawolves in the game. The couple goals that went in, you know, good deflection past him. Another one was a scrum on the side of the net with on a power play. Defense just not able to keep their hands or their eyes on Cobrid. And these are the types of goals that are going to get scored. But you got to come back and score a goal or two.
Yeah,
and I've not seen the level of passion yet from the Seawolves that they're going to need to have. You know, they're going to need to bring more of a game and more heart in the second period.
We're
ready to go. Starting the second period here. On the faceoff will be Crockett, and he'll go up against Schwier. Soski and Polishek are tangling a little bit. Now it's picked up by Schurting. Schurting will try to dump in, and Bozer can't get it deep. Just out of the reach of Schurting. Shot right on. There's a rebound picked up by the Seawolves. Here comes Olszewski through center ice. Being watched and checked from behind. He'll dump in. Bozer uses his speed. Gets it deep. Throws it out in front of Olszewski. Crockett just a little late getting to the puck. Could not get a shot off on that loose puck. Backhanded in by Schurting and then knocked down. Seawolves need to keep vigilant on skating without the puck is another thing. And that shot's from the corner. Comes right out to Schurting, and he'll get it up to Olszewski. Olszewski and also staying on the long shift change here. Olszewski making a nice move, and then he'll just lose the handle. Throws it to the front of the net, looking for a deflection. Nothing got through. Back to the point. Kasha winds and fires a shot right on. Gobbled up by Roundebush. And that you're going to have to see a lot more of that in this period.
Yeah, Kasha took it was a little bit of like a knuckle puck action. And Hall was sitting right there for the deflection, and Roundebush gets right up in Hall's face, gets that puck, hangs on to it. I agree with you. They need to get shots in the net. They need to get those open lanes.
Faceoff won by the Seawolves. Zaldi picks it up, goes back behind the net, throws it back behind to Hall. Hall just tries to throw it to the net, but nothing got through. And now here comes Adrian through the neutral zone. Off the mark and on the pass to Anstett. Back to get it is Cartwright. Cartwright just throws it up the wall out into the neutral zone. Picked up by Hall. Hall through the neutral zone. Into the Adrian zone. And Lozaldi trying to get it deeper, but couldn't get it further. This is Colburn carrying it. Wrist shot. Oh, off the blocker of Wilms. Fired out in front. Net is off the moorings, and we'll have a face-off in the Seawolves zone. Colburn with a hard wrist shot, blockered to the corner by Wilms. And I think Wilms' momentum took him back and knocked the net off.
Yeah, what I've actually seen for most of this game, what Adrian is specifically Roundebush has done, he's controlled rebounds. He's not letting Stonerbrook get those second and third chances.
Yeah, where Adrian Wilms is letting up some rebounds more obviously tonight. And again, some of that could be nerves, and some of it could just be good hard shots. Zaldi taking the draw for Halls. He was pushed out of the faceoff circle. Rakus and throws it back behind the net to Dwart, and Dwart sends it around, and at the point is McKinnon, who fires a hard shot and was knocked down, never got to the goal. This is McKinnon getting it now, picking it up for Adrian. Fires back to the neutral zone. Big hit by Kasha. And back into the Seawolves zone. Cartwright back to get it as he's watched by Durachi. Through the neutral zone come the Seawolves. Lozaldi was skating, waiting for the pass, but it fluttered on him. Back up the wall, and this will go all the way down. This will be an icing on Adrian. The Seawolves will get an offensive draw here, and they can make a full change. And Zatola's having some words with referee Pincus. Face-off will be to the right of Roundebush, and it'll be Zatola on the draw. And he'll be going up against Dwart. And Dwart wins the face-off. Back behind the net. Seawolves fighting hard for it. That's the Feo. Picks it up for the Stony Brook Seawolves. And he's squeezed off and unable to get to the puck. Good play defensively there. Taking two Seawolves out of the play and able to get the puck out was Adrian. Back to the point, and the puck was out of the zone. They got a touch back up. Picked up by Miller through the neutral zone. Cross ice dump. And to get it to Satola. On him is Hosky. Zatola picks it up. He's got the fail. Fail shoots. Blocked by another Adrian play. That's Fisher blocking that shot. This will go all the way down. Again, it'll be another icing. And here's the scenario again. Fisher is standing right in front of DeFeo.
Standing
right in front of him, and he still shot the puck.
Yeah, and we've been seeing that all game. They don't move around to get that extra little bit of space.
Yeah, just take another couple of steps, make a move, do a drop and drag, and then shoot it. Picked up by Satola, and he'll have the faceoff against Fisher. Satola wins the draw back. Shirley fires it. It's right on goal. And Ronnebush soared all the way in. Nobody in front of the net trying to screen him, but that shot was right in the breadbasket. So faceoff again to the right of Ronnebush. Satola on the draw against Fisher. And kind of a standoff right now. Going to have a penalty here. Probably interference, a holding on Adrian.
This is a big chance here for the Seawolves. They can get a goal here.
And going in the penalty box will be Gettle, the captain of Adrian. Another power play opportunity for the Seawolves here. They need to get on the board. Got to figure out a way to get a puck past Ronnebush. He's played awesome so far.
Yeah, Ronnebush has been excellent in net. And, you know, there's a reason why he's the number four goalie in all of ACHA.
Face off to the right. Won by the Seawolves. Back to the point to Cartwright. Throws it cross ice. Back to the point to Schurting. Schurting knocks it down. Sends it down. Low. There's a rebound. Oh,
wow.
Underhill robbed.
He was point blank. And Ronnebush just throws the glove out, makes a save, and made it look easy.
Now, last year, Seawolves had the luxury of Derek Wilms being the number one goalie for almost the whole season. So it's important to have a great goalkeeper. Back to the point to Schurting. Schurting sends it down low. There's a rebound. Deflection is a goal. In the net. Deflection in the net on a power play goal. The shot from Schurting. We'll see who touched it. It might have been Lizaldi. I'm not sure. We'll see.
Yeah, well, let's look at the
Seawolves finally on the board.
Here comes the kick out.
Good play
by Schurting. Hall kicks it out. Schurting takes the quick shot.
Low shot so it can be deflected.
And it looks like it was either deflected.
Yeah, I think it could have been Lizaldi. It might have been
Hall. It's either Hall or Lizaldi.
Seawolves finally break through at 16:35 of the second period on their 16th shot. Let's see if this wakes the Seawolves up and maybe they get going here.
That was a goal they needed, and they needed to get it on the power play so they can kind of get things back together, get the momentum going, get the crowd into it a little bit.
This is Underhill now for the Seawolves, carrying it up through the neutral zone. Pass into the corner. Lizaldi skating. It's going to be an icing as Hall sent it ahead.
Seawolves power play goal. Score number 17.
They're going to give credit to Hall. And for Hall, that's going to be his 11th goal of the season, his 30th point of the year. So coming into this game, he was only 1 point behind Coburn in terms of points. Now he's still just a point behind.
Right.
Well, he's working his way up the rankings of the ACHA points leaders. Those two guys from Lehigh, though, they're just like far away ahead of everybody.
All right, Lasalda coming down on left wing. Pulls up, then pulls out. Still controlling the puck. Throws it back behind the net. Back to get it as Crockett. Comes back behind the net. Over to Underhill. Underhill controls the puck. Back across the shot. Love to the corner by Ronnebush. Pinching in is Miller. And fired out into the neutral zone. Picked up by Bishop. Hoisted through the neutral zone. Picked up by Ososki. And banged in back by Bozer. Bozer coming in with speed on the left side. Coming in behind the net. Bozer tried to throw it out in front. And it hit the side of the net. Picked up by Crockett. Throws it back behind the net to Ososki. Stonybrook trying to use that speed and that shiftiness is what they got to do. Because that's their skill level. That's what they bring to the table here. Coming in. Is he going to come in? Yes, Gilbert is going to finally decide to come in to get the puck. As it's hoisted out to the neutral zone. This is Coburn coming down left wing. This is being watched by Schurting. Schurting throws a check on him, but Coburn gets the better of it. Back out in front. Oh, almost tapped in again.
Yeah, and then we're seeing Adrian get into the slot. Stonybrook defense is not.
Coburn is in the Stonybrook's head, and I think they need to just get that out of their heads because, truthfully, shot high, wide over the top of the net. I really think it's in their heads, and they just need to. Oh, this is a good move here around Kasha, but it goes to the corner. Kasha, good defensive play to take off the puck. Now, Shosky trying to get a pass from Kasha, and I think that's another good idea for the Seawolves to try those passes and try to get some run type passes done.
Anything to try to break up the defense to get those open spaces, because doing the compact passes the Bulldogs are right on top of
him. There's no room. So it's almost like you got to try for a breakout pass. You got to break a forward. As soon as possession in the zone happens, you got to get somebody going. Like right now.
Yeah, right there is perfect.
Here's Boudreaux coming one-on-one. Here's Boudreaux coming in. Fires a shot. Saved by Rondebush.
And again, Rondebush just hangs on to that puck, not letting it bounce away. He just watches it right into his chest, gets the glove on it, and hangs on. And that's something that the Seawolves, if they get those second and third chances, they better convert on them because they're not going to be many.
We'll keep an eye on when the Stony Brook Seawolves catch possession in their zone if they fly a winger out of the zone. Face off to the right of Rodebush. This is Satole on the draw with the Feo. And Kalolo on D is Kasha and Cartwright. Face off back to the point to Cartwright. Cartwright down low on the half wall to Kalolo. Kalolo just loses the puck and gives it back. Picked up by DeFeo to Satole. And the Seawolves doing their best to keep moving. Keep that puck moving. Keep their legs moving. DeFeo now comes back behind the net. Loose puck behind the net. Picked up by Adrian and they'll break out. And that puck is deflected into the rafters by Kalolo. Much better skating effort right now by the Seawolves. They just need to keep that going.
And like Coach Garofalo said at the end of the first period, Adrian can hit, but they can't hit what they can't catch. So the Seawolves have to continue to use that speed that they have to get away from the back check of the Bulldogs.
All right, face off at center ice. Satola's going to be on the draw. And he'll go up against Schwier. Face off one by the Seawolves. Kalolo back to Cartwright. Cartwright will gain the zone and dump it in. Back up the wall. Satola coming hard on the forecheck. Seawolves got a turnover. Picked up by DeFeo, getting it back behind to Kalolo. Kalolo controls the puck. Back to Satola. Back to Kalolo. Fires a shot and a save by Rondebush. And there was a rebound there. We haven't seen much of that tonight.
No. And Satola was charging for it. And Rondebush just jumps right on top of it.
DeFeo wasn't too far away from that. And that's one of the things the Seawolves got to start doing is those dirty goals, as Coach Hodnicki said from Adrian. Got to be able to score some dirty goals, and that's the spot you got to score a dirty goal for.
Yeah, you know, I've forgotten how many times you've said it, but most goals are scored within 5 feet of the net. Those are the ones that are the most important.
All right, faceoff won by Adrian. And now that's an offsides play right there. It's two players come together. Play was offsides. I'm not sure why they didn't blow the whistle, but now we're going to have a penalty here. Penalty's going to be called. I think they waved the offsides off.
Yeah, because Balovich came in, and Adrian had touched up, so then once Hall fell and that puck was free, Balovich was coming in unimpeded.
Right, Balovich is going to go, I think he's going to sit for 2 minutes. And maybe, it's Heffernan is going. Heffernan is getting the penalty for interference. Okay. He's trying to plead his case, but the call's been made. Seawolves now on the PK. So far, they're 0-for-2. Adrian's 2-for-2 on the power play. So this is a real momentum switch going to happen here, one way or the other. The Seawolves are going to kill it off, or Adrian's going to get back to a three-goal lead.
And right, so on
McLean on the draw against Crockett. Crockett's tossed now, and Gervasi will come in.
Adrian 1-for-1 on the power play. He scored. Coburn scored his second goal of the game on the power play.
Back to the point. Wines fires and shot off of Gervasi over the net, high and wide. Adrian moving the puck well here. Shot down low, trying to get it across to the back door. Seawolves defending here, trying to kill off this power play. 1:40 left to go in the man advantage. And Adrian keeps moving. They keep the puck moving. They keep their bodies moving. Sign of a good power play.
Yeah, and you're seeing people move in and out of the slot, getting those quality chances.
Wilms is leaving rebounds out that he should not be leaving out. And that's giving Adrian that second and third opportunity.
And we're also seeing the Seawolves not get control of the puck. They can't clear. So especially now with a long change, they need to get those clears. They need to get them off.
Miller unable to get that puck out. He had a chance and not able to get it out. Gobbled up by Wilms at the net. It's Coburn. Right there on the doorstep.
Yeah, that Wilms had the puck. He popped out as the whistle was blowing. But again, that was a big whistle for the Seawolves. They needed to get a change out there. But they need to get control of the puck off these rebounds and clear it out. They need to get the puck out of the zone, relieve some pressure off of Wilms.
Face off to the right of Wilms. JT Hall on the draw for the Seawolves. And JT Hall wins it, fires it high and over the net. Out of the rink, actually, over the glass it went. So it'll be face off back in the Seawolves zone. Heffernan still sitting out for another minute on the interference call. 12:04 left to go in the first period. 59 seconds left to go in the man advantage for Adrian. Face off to the right of Wilms. Dwart and JT Hall on the draw. They'll do it again. And loose puck here. Picked up by the Seawolves. This is Lizaldi. Lizaldi breaking in on right wing. Coming in. Pushed off the puck by Zach McKay. And they're going to call a penalty on McKay. Maybe an interference call?
Yeah, they're calling interference on him.
So an interference call on McKay, and we'll have some 4-on-4 action for another 50 seconds, and then Seawolves will go up for a power play for about a minute and 10. Say faceoff will be inside the Adrian zone.
And this is a good chance here for the Seawolves. A lot of open ice now, 4-on-4, and then they get the power play. They've already scored one. So they can get some momentum rolling here. You have your big line out there with Fallen Underhill. And two of the guys that do have some size on this team that can go up against this back check.
Adrian fouling number 7, Zach McKay. 2 minutes of interference. Time of fouling, 11:55 remaining, second period. McKay, 2 for interference, 11:55.
Shot from the point, saved by Wilms. And Underhill's playing this like it's a power play, a penalty kill. And now the Stony Brook gets the puck, and Hall's shot was knocked down by
Kettle. Sitting in there. But again, now we're seeing shots blocked from all angles of this ice, even up at the blue line.
Adrian's picking up the puck, coming on goal, shot. It's blocked down by Miller. I don't think the puck got to the net. Seawolves now got a power play. For another minute and 5 seconds to go, picked up by Underhill. This is DeFeo through the neutral zone. Touch pass through to Satola, who takes a weak shot, gobbled up by Radibush.
That was just a wrister just to get it on net. See if maybe it could take some funky bounce or deflect off somebody.
Or get a face off so they could get the change made that I think they want made right now. They've got Ososki, DeFeo and Satola out there with Cartwright and Schurting.
I think the big one was getting the defensive unit out there. Getting Schurting out there. His assist is the catalyst of that goal.
Schurting to the point from Cartwright. Over to Ososki trying to get something through, but back Schurting down low to DeFeo. DeFeo just trying to get control of the puck over to Satola. Throws it around the wall to Cartwright. Smart play by Satola. Getting it over to Schurting, fires a one-timer, but didn't get all of it. Back behind the net to DeFeo, back to Ososki, back to Satola. Seawolves moving the puck well here. Here's an opportunity. Maybe these one-time passes could be one-time shots if they were on the stick. Back to DeFeo, back to Ososki, back to the point to Schurting. Schurting's got the shot. He's not taking it, though. As those shooting lanes are blocked there, so Schurting can't get that shot through, but now it's picked up by Schurting over to Gilbert as we are now all even up. Gilbert through the neutral zone, fires it in deep, behind the net.
We're all even up, and they got only one shot on the power play.
Yeah, one shot's not going to do it, guys.
No.
This is Adrian coming up through the neutral zone, number 23. Blalovich sends it across to number 22. That's Johnston in the corner, controlling it. Back behind the net is Fisher. Fisher back up to the point. Rakes sends it down low, deflected into the corner, back behind the net. Picked up by Adrian, controlling the puck very well. Seawolves are not getting their sticks on it much in their own zone.
Yeah, they're letting the pucks bounce around and giving Adrian more chances to keep the puck in the zone, getting
They've
those
chances. They've got to take possession of the puck.
They have to get possession of the puck, get it out of there, and start
rush. This almost looks like a power play. That's it, and Wilms dives on it because he's seen enough.
He knows that needs to happen.
Yeah, I think, if anything, right now, they need to be making their shifts shorter and trying to get in 30-second shifts, get on, get off, get on, get off, because right now, their energy is getting zapped. and they need to keep moving because Adrian is changing more frequently.
And the longer that those shifts go, the more steam Adrian gets because they have change into the as they can keep a sustained rush because
That was a weird collision there between number 10 Peters and number 27 Coburn. Back to the point. And Miller just decides to pull out.
Coming down on left wing.
He just, there's that touch pass, trying to make that touch pass again. Little hooking on the stick there, but coming around Zalzaldi. He's got Hall with him. Hall tried to make a move around number four, Rakus. Rakus did a good job holding his ground.
Yeah, Rakus with a smart play there, put the stick out, got it twisted in between Hall and the puck, and led to a turnover.
Seawolves have to move. And they need to change. They need to change.
They're getting their change. So Miller takes a good shot into the boards from McKay.
Soski on the ice. Throws it deep to Bozer. Bozer, he's banged in the corner by Alden. Back behind the net is Crockett. He's battling with McKay. Picked up by Soski. Soski trying to work behind the net. Being checked. Oh, now we get a penalty. As I think Gettle's going to go. Not Gettle, it's going to be Baudet is going to probably go for a hold. And the Seawolves will once again go on the power play. We're down to 7:35 left to go in the second period. Adrian up on the Seawolves by the score of 3-1. And faceoff will be inside the Adrian zone to the left of Radebush. And it's Satola on the draw for the Seawolves, won by Adrian.
This is now going to be the fifth power play for the Seawolves. They're 1-for-4 thus far.
Yeah.
They need to score here because they need to convert on these special teams opportunities that they're being handed because Adrian is using their size and they're taking penalties because of it, because of the fact that Soderbrook is not
as
big.
They've got to get their opportunities and they've got to inch their way back in this game. And right now they're not doing it this way.
No.
Very, very sloppy, sloppy play right now. And they need to get their...
Yeah, they got to get better communication on the passes. They have to watch the shooting lane, see when it opens up, and not shoot right into somebody's pads.
And right now, Adrian's really taking advantage of their size and knocking the smallest Stony Brook players down, and it's just sad. It's sad.
We're watching Asaski here.
The referee has to make when a play like that happens, the referee has to make a call. I'm sorry. It's after the whistle, and the player never even had possession of the puck. So it's just called taking your liberties.
As you watch this game, you're watching pretty much everybody on the Seawolves. Anytime they get near the puck, they're on the ice time and time again because Adrian is just bullying them away from the puck.
And the Seawolves are going to have to battle really hard here. And again, you can't complain for what they're doing because they're playing the game of hockey inside the game of hockey.
Yeah, Lizzo,
you know, they're playing that game that teams learn how to play, and it's hooking and grabbing and clutching and everything else.
And when you're a team that big, you're going to get
away with it
because you have that size advantage. It's like, hey, I'm a big guy. This is what is expected of me.
Well, the refs are going to let them get away with it too because they do it. It's almost unnoticeable, but it's noticeable to the smaller player who's just getting hooked for 2 seconds. But back to the point to Schurting, fires it and it hits one of the Stony Brook players. Back to the point again to Schurting. Down low, back to Schurting. Trying to get that tic-tac-toe, that one-time shot pass. Hall back around the wall to Lazzaldi. Lazzaldi picks it up. Seawolves getting something going here. Now we're starting to get the whistle blowing. Net is off the moorings. And Adrian can't change here.
No, they're saying
they can't change.
They
can't.
Is intentionally kicked
no,
off.
No, 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 they can't change. They can't change. Referee's got his hand up. Cannot change. Once the net's knocked off by them, they cause the stoppage.
Yeah.
So
this is a good chance here for the Seawolves.
This is a
25 seconds left here on the power play.
But they're changing now. Now they're letting them change. So I don't understand what this is. Coach Garofalo, his arms are out. He's fuming.
And yeah, he has legitimate beef with that. He has a case. As
he's fuming.
Gets
and they changed the whole line. Well, now they got to come back out. So, right. Yeah, but still, by this point in time, they've taken five breaths and they're back in their he changed the whole line.
Yeah, there's a whole bunch of confusion going on, where should they be taken off? Should they not be?
Yeah. So faceoff will be to the right of Radebush, and it's 26 seconds left to go in the man advantage. And that's one thing that the referee's got to explain to the coaching staff is now Radebush is going to stall for time here. He's going to fix his glove. He's got a pad out. His belt broke. So this is all the game within the game.
Yeah, it's a psychological thing.
Yeah, what they do. It's what they do.
Well, that looks like he's taking his sweet time.
So it's just knowing how to play the game within the game. Back to the point. Seawolves are going to have to beat them on the board, and that's the way they're going to have to beat them. So back to the point to Cartwright. They're not going to beat him in the physical game. Just beat him on the board. Down low. Oh, chance just past DeFeo. Picked up by Schurting down low. And DeFeo has it. Back up to the point to Wasoski. You can't hold it in. And the Seawolves have to all come out. And he just hoists it into the rafters. And he'll be face-off outside the zone.
And now we're back at even strength, too.
Right.
So Stony Brook now 1-for-5 on the power play.
Squandering opportunity after opportunity.
They're being given the opportunities because Adrian's taking a lot of penalties because of their physical play, and the Seawolves have not been able to capitalize as Satola now throws a shove. He's lucky nobody saw it. It seems like frustration is starting to get the better of
It's too early in the game for that. You got a whole nother period to go. Yeah, this referee, Pincus, is having a discussion with the Adrian coach, but they probably should have talked to them in the beginning about the nets coming off the moorings. In this rink, they come off very easily. And the team that knocks it off to cause the stoppage cannot have a change.
There was one in the first period where the net came off, and it was there because the puck was going down on the other end. The net just stayed up the moorings for a good 30 seconds before the whistle blew.
Face off and just outside the Stony Brook zone. Gervaisi, Boudreaux, and Stemke. And this puck's going to go all the way down, and it should be an icing, but beating Gilbert to the puck with some good wheels was Polacek. Boudreaux battling down low. This game is getting real physical.
Man, I mean, it's been ramped up to 100 at this point.
And now that puck is fired out of the rink, and Face will be back in the Seawolves zone.
Yeah, you're seeing the physicality from both ends just being ramped up. Just an extra notch or two every shift. And what the Seawolves have to do now, they cannot go and take a bad penalty. They just have to roll with it. Throw some checks around, but don't get yourself caught.
Be physical, but be vigilant. You know, don't. And then Fisher just nails Gervaisi on the faceoff with a stick. I mean, just not on purpose, but just things happen. Boudreaux dumps in for the Seawolves. Chases after it. Back off the wall by Radebush. Pushed back in by the Seawolves, now picked up by Adrian. Dumped in. Chasing after it is Johnson. Boudreaux has to go get it. Fisher on Boudreaux. Gilbert trying it. Got it on the backhand. Banks it off the wall through the neutral zone, but just not anywhere near Boudreaux. Back into the Seawolves zone. Fisher on the forecheck for Adrian. Back up the wall. Gilbert to Stemke, who can't control it. And picked up by Adrian again. And they control behind the Seawolves zone. Back to the point and out. Seawolves need to get a line change. They have to change up.
Yeah, now
this is not a good matchup for them right now.
And they can't get anybody off the ice. Stunky gonna make the dash for it so they can at least get one.
Yep. And Gervaisi. This is gonna go all the way past the goaltender. It'll be icing. Unfortunately, they can't change. Seawolves have to do a better job controlling the puck in their zone.
Yeah, they need to get control of the puck. They need to make better breakout passes. Any breakout pass they're making, they're putting it wide, or it's being blocked by Adrian and just kept right in the zone.
Adrian's keeping the game close by only having 23 shots on goal, but I mean, it's not a close game.
Stony Brook is getting outplayed in many facets of this game. And That's not going to bode well if they can't convert on the opportunity that they've been given.
Back to the point, Adrian fires in and glove down by Wilms, standing right in front of was McLean. It's a big guy, 6'3", 215, standing right in front of Wilms.
You would think that he'd be playing wide receiver for their team. That'd be a nice size advantage that he'd have over most cornerbacks too.
Yeah, we talked a little bit about this, but they have actually 14 players that are 6 foot or better.
That's a lot of people.
And the Seawolves have 8.
And two of the 14 that Adrian has are their goalies. Rodebush is 6'3", and Snows is 6'2".
Another thing too is I'm noticing, if you watch how the defense plays for Adrian, they stand up at the blue line. They don't back in. Yeah, they'll force you with the blue line.
Yeah, they'll play up and
the Seawolves defense does not force at the blue line. They back in.
They want to try to keep people out of the low slot.
All right, we got a penalty being called here, and we'll see who it's going to be. It'll be an interference call, and it looks like an Adrian player going off. It might be McLean, and it is. Seawolves will go on power play number
six.
Faceoff will be to the right around the bush, and Seawolves really need to try to get this game narrowed down here. Yeah, they got to get one here to try to get this to a 3-2 game.
Yeah, if they can make it a 3-2 game by the end of the period, that's going to give them a little bit of a momentum boost going into the third, and having two power play goals to their credit is also going to be a nice boost.
All right, Hall on the draw for the Seawolves. And it's won by Adrian. Good defensive draw. Faceoff win there by number 12. That's Anstett.
Anstett's
strong on the faceoff.
Anstett has won faceoff after faceoff, especially in his own zone. And that's been really, really big for the Bulldogs to keep Sonnenbrook away.
Underhill
from
breaking
net.
In, coming in around the net. He has Azaldi in front, but the pass was on his skate, not his stick.
That's been what we've seen. Drive after drive here by the Seawolves. A lot of passes into the skates.
Yeah,
nothing.
I mean,
the tape.
Anything on the tape would have been a goal.
It's impossible to get quality shots if you can't make tape-to-tape passes.
Paul coming in with the puck, making a move, going around the net. Has Lazaldi. Lazaldi back to Schurting at the point. Schurting throws a wrist shot right on. Nobody in front of Rodebush. Nobody.
Yeah, you see.
He saw the shot coming all the way in.
Yeah, like Hall was on one side of him. Cartwright was coming in on the other. Underhill was completely out of the picture. So that's, when there's nobody in front of you screening it, that puck's going to look like a beach ball coming at you.
He's basically seen almost all those types of shots tonight. So faceoff to the right, around the bush. Satola on the draw. He's out to Olszowski, Crockett, Kasha, and Theo at the point. This is Crockett down low to Satola. He throws it back behind the net, being watched carefully, and then he's got to move the puck. Olszowski now with it. Olszowski trying to control it. He gets it back down to Satola. Satola on his backhander. He's got nowhere to go. That wall is being blocked there, so that point shot can't go. Back up to the point here. Nope. Back to Kasha. Kasha just going to control it, make a move, and shoot! That's what you got to do. You got to find that open ice to get that shot. Kasha did a good job there.
And as you watch them set up, Azowski is sitting right in front of Rodebush.
Crockett with the puck down low.
You can't even see him down.
Back to Kasha. Kasha, why is it fires? Oh, over the top of the glove. Kasha's shooting that puck. He's got a heavy shot. He should be taking a lot of them tonight on the power play. Him and Schurting both.
He's got 4 power play goals on the season. So, when he gets the puck, you expect him to fire.
18 seconds to go in the man advantage. Up to DeFeo through the neutral zone. DeFeo walks it in. And Olszowski picked up. Back to Kasha. Oh, just out of the reach. Kasha racing hard. And that puck is batted into the scorer's box.
A smart play by Kasha just to knock that away because Johnson had him beat by a good step.
Yeah, Kasha's not fleet of foot, and Johnson was coming hard.
Now Johnson would have had an unimpeded breakaway for a potential shorthanded opportunity.
He had Kasha at a disadvantage. He was almost in a run state. Kasha was kind of getting going, but couldn't get there. Able to at least deflect it out, prevent that potential breakaway. And we're all even up now. That back checking from the Seawolves needs to get better. Right there. Oh, what a save of the night! What a save by Wilms, sticking that pad out.
Biggest save of the night there for Derek Wilms, keeping this a two-goal game, because that would have been deflating.
You got to watch this, folks. Yeah, this was the save of the night.
We need to see that again. Here comes the rush. Ansett just leaves it out for McLean. Here comes McLean. Gets past Miller. Takes the shot. There's the initial kick save. Now the rebound. Coburn going for his hat trick, and Wilms just kicks it out.
And again, Coburn, you know, just you can't leave him inside the inside the slot area. You got to have a man on him.
He will make you pay, as we've seen in this
There's
game.
Another two-on-one possibility. Oh, no, but the net was off the moorings.
They're saying the goal crossed the
line. I don't know. I think the net was off before it crossed the line. But it's going to be a goal because it was unabated. And again, this is a bad zone coverage by the Seawolves. Down low.
That should be Anstead getting credit for that goal. So we're going to watch it again.
The net was still on.
The net was coming up. It wasn't off before that puck hit the red line.
All right. Stony Brook now down by three again. You can't count the opportunities, how many they had with all the power play chances that they've had in this game. You just got to shake your head. They're really giving them too much room, too much liberty.
Yeah.
You know, there's no body checking.
Because any body check that the Seawolves will throw just bounce right off.
And Oshoski is just never going to get through going through the behemoths like that. That's not going to happen. Gilbert throwing it back behind, trying to get it back behind the net. Picked up by Crockett. Crockett will just throw it deep and in the corner. And that's the end of the period. As got a couple of players getting together there at the end. Frustration really settling in on the Seawolves.
And this is a game where they can't let their frustration get the better. They have to keep a cool head about it.
I mean, that's Brian Boeser. And Brian Boeser is not that type of player. So you know the frustration level is huge.
Boeser is very level-headed.
Yeah.
So that's not something you see very often.
Well, the Seawolves knew they were going to be in for a fight. And they are in a dogfight right now. They're going to have to really, really come back in a big way to make this a game. Right now they're down by three through two periods. 4-1, Adrian. We'll be back for the start of the third period. You're watching Seawolves Hockey Live. Welcome back to Seawolves Hockey Live, everyone. Andy Mignani and Andy Sukoff. Andy, we are heading into the third period. Adrian has a commanding 4-1 lead. Stony Brook is going to need a mighty tall task.
Yeah, and they're going to need to score quick in this period. Get it back to a two-goal deficit and do whatever they can to get back into this game. But this, like Coach Garofalo said to you, this is a big test and the most important test of the year. And right now, Adrian is winning in every facet of the game. Physicality, shooting, defense. I mean, Stony Brook has 23 shots on goal, and I'm still pretty sure that they've blocked just as many shots. But you would think that if those shots weren't being blocked, the Stony Brook would have close to 50 shots at this point in the game.
Yeah. We appreciate the comments we're getting from all our our fans. We have no fans. We have friends that are telling us how good we're doing out there. We apologize for the video feed. Really nothing we can do about it. We don't control it, but we hope this facility will do something about it one day soon and be able to get a good strong signal so we could bring you this beautiful high definition broadcast for free.
I say, if anything, if we can get it done tomorrow, And we'll be back here tomorrow for a noon puck drop against Adrian.
Yeah, we might not have like 150 people banging the internet here, so.
That's true.
All right. Yeah, they say some of the comments, it says, not real bad, but not as good as it always is. So, all righty. All right, we got to get started now. Start of the third period, the Seawolves will start with J.T. Hall, as there are two men in the penalty box, one from each team. J.T. Hall wins the face, walks in, tries to get it through. Good defensive play by Adrian Gettle. Back, that was a swing and a miss there by Kasha, but he eventually got the shot off. Adrian coming up through the neutral zone. This is Coburn, fires a wrist shot right on goal and saved by Wilmsy. He didn't have it. And then Kasha gets bashed into by Fisher, and that's the way they play, man. That's why that whistle blows.
They don't mess around. They will they will throw their weight around until.
That was pretty a dangerous play there because Kasha crashed right into Wilms. Face off to the left of Wilms. It's Hall on the draw again against Fisher. One back by Hall. Caught right over to his partner, Kasha. Out to the neutral zone, picked up by Hall. He's one on two, coming in on right wing. Takes a stick up high and then controls the puck. To Kasha turns wide, fires a shot, just missed. Picked up by Lizaldi behind the net.
Actually, that might have been a pass to Lizaldi.
Back to the point, shot right on, a screenshot there as Hall was in front of the net. Caught right, putting a good low shot down. Coming in, nice play there. By Kasha to stay with Coburn as he got that shot off, but didn't get much on it. And now this is hoisted out to the neutral zone. It's going all the way down. This will probably be an icing.
Okay, so coming back down into the Stony Brook zone. That's not what they.
All right, face off to the left. Of Wilms, it's J.T. Hall on a draw again. And face-off won by Adrian, back to the point. Controlled by Alden. Alden sends it down, back behind the net. Picked up by Baudet. He's pushed off by Kasha. Picked up by Cartwright, sends it back to Kasha, but he was not able to get to the loose puck. Now Adrian playing with the puck, walking in, not getting that shot off. Back to the point to Alden. He fires it on, a save by Wilms. Little miscommunication by the D down low with Kasha and Cartwright. Kind of both went off the wall and down in front of Wilms, enabling Wart to get that pass and then that shot, eventual shot by Alden to the net. Face off won by Seawolves. Now back to Alden. All the way around the wall. Picked up by Baudet. Fires it down. Picked up by Schoening. Just trying to get it to. But now he gets it back, picked up by Schoening, as he fires it to Underhill, coming down left wing. Underhill going to take it back behind the net. You can watch there by Alden. And battling hard. That was a bad penalty to take there by Underhill. That was the worst penalty you could ever take.
Yeah, and he's looking at the ref like what did I do, but.
Yeah, so now I think he actually got both guys, and they're both going to go. But Underhill's going to go, and he's a guy that of size, for the Seawolves,
and one they needed out there.
Someone who can bring some, 6'2", 200 pounds, and he should be able to bring some kind of power strength and power forwardness. And he takes a penalty like that, and that's going to put the Seawolves in a bad situation right now. Already down by 3 goals, and already let up 3 power play goals. To Adrian, back behind the wall, all the way up to the point. And Gervaisi trying to get it out, could not. Kept in by Adrian. Oh, wind and shot by Coburn. And a blocker save.
Coburn wants a hat trick. He's taking shots. He's being very aggressive out there. And the Seawolves have to contain that. They cannot let quality shots get into the net.
And I got to be honest with you. If the Seawolves were smart, they really would watch when Coburn carries the puck. Sometimes his head is down.
Yeah,
and that's a very dangerous way to skate. But nobody challenges him.
Yeah, we've seen that a lot.
Back to the point. Rakus. And that shot is blocked.
Good block there by Crockett. And in turn, kicks it out of the zone.
And again, that was an ill-advised shot by Anstead because Crockett was right in front of him. But when you're up by 3 goals, you can take those chances, I guess. And we got a whistle here. for an offsides. Yep. That's a good block by Crockett.
Yeah, you might be watching Adrian a little bit, watching how they're blocking shots and being very successful at it. It's a way to do it. Keeps pucks away from the net. One less shot that once that's
stopped. Face-off was in the neutral zone. I believe the referee may have blown the call, so they do it in the face-off in the center ice zone. Cristoracci nailed. Big hit there by JT Hall. Finally, Seawolves got a body check.
That was the first big hit they've had all game.
Hall now breaking down on through the neutral zone, in the zone. And, oh. And Mazzoli was hit high with a stick right in the face.
You know, college hockey players are very lucky they had that cage in front. Yeah, otherwise, that could have been a very serious injury.
Durachi took that big hit on the wall, and I guess he was trying to pay somebody back, and he went after Lazaldi, much smaller player, and came up with the stick, caught him in the chops. We're going to have a little four-on-four action here for another 45 seconds. The Seawolves will go on a power play for a brief minute and 15 seconds. Face off to the left of Brownabush. And it's Satola for the Seawolves along with Ososki. Oh, nice defensive play there. Take away that golden scoring opportunity. Adrian moving the puck very well. Picked up by Kasha over to Gilbert, but Gilbert now has it. And he'll settle it down and get it to Ososki through the neutral zone, but off his stick and skate back to Gilbert. This is being chased down by Baudette. Throws it back up the wall to Ososki. Ososki skating with the puck through the neutral zone to Satola. Satola loses it on the stick check, and then Gilbert sent it in offsides. Again, we said it earlier in the game. They're still doing it now. They stand you up at the blue line, and
that's what's been working for them.
You have to chip and chase it, and that's where Stony Brook has missed the mark all game because they have more speed.
Yeah, that hasn't been their style. They drive their way into the net. That's going to be offside. That was bad miscommunication. Lazaldi wasn't really looking where he was passing on that one.
Yeah, but Hall really needs to be there on that play. He's got to be there. Put your stick ahead of you. Get there. The little miscommunications have kind of hurt the Seawolves tonight. Hopefully they're going to be able to rebound and get it all squared away before the end of the night.
At least if anything, just to get some confidence going into tomorrow's game.
Yeah. It's Cartwright carrying it. He'll dump in. Right here is the way you got to get in, make your play, get the puck back to the point, man. Get it to the net. That's the way you do it, Cartwright. Get that puck to the net quickly as you can. Get that opportunity.
They also have to have somebody in front of the net who can make that deflection. After Underhill was standing in front, he slid out, and that left
31 seconds left to go.
Nobody in front of him to block the puck.
31, 29 to go with the man advantage for the Seawolves. And Cartwright fanned on it. And right now, Adrian just controlling the puck, taking time off that clock and not allowing the Seawolves to get anything going on this peak on this power play.
And we're seeing right now, they only put one forward, and now they all three of the defense just stay right back, forcing the Seawolves to dump and chase.
Yeah, and this is where you have to make your move right now. You got to go get that puck. Good play by Satola, holding the stick up of the defenseman and not allowing him to get possession. Picked up by, back to the point, to Kasha. Kasha moving, fires it down low, rebound opportunity. And backhanded by Colillo, did not get to the net. Back to the point, Kasha shoots. That's actually Schurting with the shot.
A lot of these shots
should be staying in the zone there instead of vacating the zone. Saved by Wilms.
A lot of these shots that we're seeing getting blocked by Adrian just have absolutely no velocity on them. So what the shooting, it could be open all at once, but with no velocity on the shot, the shot's going to be blocked anyway.
Yep. And we just saw Roundabush, his skill level, able to get that stick, shooting that puck out like a forward.
We've seen
a player down on the ice there, probably with a bad blade on his skate, maybe.
And we've seen it all game. Rodowicz is a very good puck handler for a goalie.
And sent around the wall. So Koski for the Seawolves and not able to move that puck as quickly as he needs to. And it's a turnover again. Kept in by Rakes, jumps it deep. Back to get Crockett, goes back behind the net. He goes after Bolovich. Battle on the wall, that puck is loose. Back behind the Seawolves zone. This line is worn out, just trying to get the puck out of the zone. And they chop it out now, and this is going to be another icing, and they'll be stuck in their zone and won't be able to change. And this is just tough for the Seawolves. They've got to battle through it.
Coming into this period, the shot total was 26-23 in favor of Adrian. Stony Brook has taken only one shot in the first 7 minutes of this period. So that Adrian's not letting them get any kind of sustained chances here.
And face off. Won by the Adrian now. The Seawolves pick it up. This is Ososki. He'll just chip it in. Bozer back to get it. And the Seawolves defense, as they're coming in to try to keep the forecheck on, are almost immediately having to turn around. And Bozer's still in the zone. Yep.
Yeah, he was hit by Coburn. Yeah, Coburn laid him out into the zone. Forrest is out going to have to hang on to the puck and wound up being Adrian putting the puck back into the defensive zone.
This is Lizaldi trying to get it to Bishop. Bishop behind the net for the Seawolves. Picked up by Hall. And nets off the mooring, and it'll be outside faceoff. We will be back again tomorrow. Tomorrow's game time is at noon. So if you are a West Coaster,
getting up a little early,
set the alarm and get a cup of coffee and watch some Seawolves hockey tomorrow morning.
And then for those of you on the East Coast, you can watch us and then watch the Giants.
If you so desire, yes. All right. This is Beaudet dumping it in. Adrian's still going 100 miles an hour.
And you should be. No matter what the score is, you want your team to be firing at all cylinders,
all times,
and moving at your highest level. There's no taking off the gas pedal.
This is Hall breaking in. He's got Underhill going with him. Underhill breaking to the net. He scores. The Seawolves break through on an actual 5-on-5 rush. Underhill determined. Got the pass from Hall and put it home.
And we're going to watch this breakout here. This is the first real sustained breakout.
And folks,
that we've
this is the
work.
Speed game that the Seawolves have to play.
And there was the perfect outlet pass.
If they play with the speed that they have, they can compete. And it's a matter of believing in yourself and that you can do that. And you know, you got to have your leaders step up. JT Hall and Underhill, Tyler Underhill stepping up here. Making it a closer game.
They still got a ways to go. We're now about halfway through this period.
And again, last time those Seawolves scored, it did inspire them a little bit. You know, they did get something going here, but now we got a 2-on-1. Oh, nice stick by Schurting. Coming back.
Yeah, big important play by Schurting.
Wow.
Get that stick out there, because there was an odd man rush here. We're going to watch it one more time. Here's the initial pass from Rizzoli to Hall. Hall drives in. He's got going complaining, and Underhill has nobody on him, as he had Peters committed to him.
And that was maybe a little bit of a mismatch with their line facing up against the...
It was a smart play by Hall, waiting until the last possible second just to hang on to that puck for that extra second, which leads to that goal for Underhill. And for Underhill, that's going to be...
Yeah. Colillo just sent Schurting into the fire there by sending him a pass that maybe he should have held on to. Schurting took the pass, but it was two players coming together hard, including Fisher. I think Fisher's hurt.
Yeah, he's getting a little slowly off the ice.
And Schurting seems to be a little slow too, but he's still out there.
And for Underhill, that's his 17th goal, which leads the team.
And looks like we're going to have an Adrian penalty.
It's going to be cross-checking.
Right now, the Seawolves have a little bit of momentum right now, and maybe this
power play is a big spot.
Could be an opportunity. And going to the box, I think, for the second time tonight is Bolovich. So Bolovich will sit for checking from behind, and the Seawolves will get on that power play again for a full 2 minutes, barring any other penalties, with 10:27 left to go. Faceoff will be to the left of Roundbush. JT Hall on the draw with Lizaldi and Underhill. Picked up by Underhill now. He tries to kick it back to Lizaldi, battling against. Back to the point. Shirting. Back across to Cartwright. Cartwright down low, wrist shot. Rebounds loose. Oh, a kick to the corner.
Again, nice position there by Roundbush.
And we need, Seawolves have to put a couple of guys on that one, on that loose puck, because they've got two guys there.
Back to
the point, Schurting missed it. Oh, all the way down to the Seawolves zone. And now
Schurting calling for the pass.
It gives him another chance to change. Underhill just not able to get that puck to his forward. Back to Call, coming through the neutral zone now. Hall over to Underhill. Underhill walking in, foot pass to Call. He shoots, he scores! Seawolves on the PK, on the power play, make it a 4-3 game. Folks, this is getting interesting.
And they've now scored two goals in the last 2 minutes.
Right now, the Seawolves just had a little bit of momentum from that last goal and were able to get on the power play now and put one home, and that's their second power play goal of the game.
Yeah, they're now 2-for-8 on the power play, so that's still not good. But that was a big goal for them to get. Now a one-goal game, half the period left to play. We watch Hall and Underhill on the replay. They just do a little give and go. Hall gets the rebound off the initial shot from Underhill and just flips it top.
Seawolves, let's see if this sparks them and they start bringing more of a game.
And they have to at this point. They now feel that they can get back in this game and tie it. Now things are starting to get in sync for them, making it work. And for Underhill, that's going to be his 7th assist this season. So he's got 2 points. Cole's got 3. That's his 12th goal. He's got 12 goals and 20 assists now on the season.
All right. That line's getting it done today.
Yeah, they are. Also for Hull, that's going to be his 2nd power play goal of the game and his 4th of the season.
All right, faceoff to the left. Wilms won by Adrian. Puck back behind the net. McKay against Kasha. We're going to have a penalty on Kasha. For holding, I think, yep. And Kasha's going to take a bad penalty.
Yeah, that was a penalty they couldn't afford to take right now.
They want to change the momentum right now. Faceoff will be to the right of Wilms. Out killing the penalty will be Crockett, Miller, Cartwright, and Gervaisi. Couldn't get that puck all the way out.
Crockett had it for a second, but he couldn't get past.
Look at the battle. Oh. Control by Adrian. Back to the point, McLean, shot. Sails wide.
Wilms, as he was sliding across, kicked the net out.
Yeah.
So they're going to stop it and play. There's just been a myriad of penalties. We've had 14 total penalties for 28 minutes.
Face off to the right of Wilms. Crockett on the draw for the Seawolves. Unable to win it. One back by, this is Alderman's shot, gloved down by Wilms. Looks like they're firing it on Wilms, trying to see if he'll drop it, get a rebound.
He's done much better in controlling the puck in the second and third period.
Yes, he has.
He's let up far fewer rebounds than he did in the first.
See, it's another faceoff won by Adrian. Down low on the one-timer's tap. Crockett trying to get it out, and the net off the boardings again. Oh, a high stick, actually.
And they say, because it looked like Schurting was trying to bat the puck out of the air, and Cartwright who was doing that, and they caught him doing so.
All right, face off to the Wilms again, and Crockett will try it once again against McLean. Against And this time he still loses it. Playing 3-for-3 against Crockett.
And the Seawolves still struggling to win.
Nice play there by Crockett to deflect the shot off of Alden, and Gervaisi banged it down.
A smart play by Gervaisi, get the change, because that line had been out there for the entirety of the penalty kill thus far.
Oh.
Nice move there in front.
Cartwright almost had a chance to line someone up, and he just missed.
And McLean spun around.
Back to the point to Colburn. Shot knocked down by Hall. Hit him in the glove.
And he's still looking for it. Hall's still feeling it. He's holding his wrist now.
Yeah, he's got – that's going to hurt. He's got a – that's going to be a problem. He caught that shot fully. And we got a Seawolf down. That's Cartwright down. Yeah, we got a penalty. We got someone going to the box. That's McLean.
Yeah, that's a.
Yeah, and actually, if we're watching that play again, that shot was right off the Hall.
Here comes McLean.
Yeah,
and he just drills him right into the board.
He already got rid of the puck. This should be more than a 2-minute penalty, folks.
I think that's what they're discussing. They might be discussing that right now. But Cartwright took a big shot.
Yeah, I mean, he saw it. The referee saw that. That's got to be more than 2 minutes. Well, that's just not a good call, unfortunately, but it is what it is. Well, 2-minute penalty for that type of hit. This doesn't seem right, but at least the Seawolves got the call, and they have the 2-minute penalty on the board. They got 54 seconds left to go in cautious penalty, and then we'll have a very short power play. Miller with the shot right on. A save by Roudbush.
You know, when that happens, it's going to be their ninth power play of the game. So generally, when you think somebody's got 9 power plays, that they should not be down 4-3.
Face off to the left of Roudbush. Shosky trying to go right to the net, and Roudbush moved it to his defenseman. Up the wall, Bishop trying to get in. Oshosky with the roll, with the deflection.
Yeah, that one was kind of rolling a little bit. Roudbush had to make sure he had that puck. That could have been a little bit of a
Seawolves. They're coming. It just takes one more. One more gets in the net. Any way he gets in there, this is a totally different game.
Yep, and then when you're back to the tie game, anything's possible.
Seawolves need to figure out a way to keep them. Big hit by Bishop. Nice big check on Gettle. Through the neutral zone comes Ososki with speed. He's got the Feo on the wing. He fakes the shot. Now walks in, fires off the blocker. Good shot. Good hard shot by Ososki. Almost had the net. Good blocker save. Pinching in is Miller, keeping that puck in. Fires it to the net. And a save. Pushed to the corner. The Feo picking up the puck now. Oh, the Feo had a chance to get that puck to Bishop. Now Seawolves on the power play. Oh, Bishop missed the check on that one. Coming out, it's Colburn. Colburn makes a nice move, trying to get around. Comes around the net. And Wilms was able to. Yeah, coming through the neutral zone is Schurting to Ososki. Ososki drops it back to Schurting. Tries to get it back down to Ososki. Picking it up now is Adrian. And they'll fire all the way down. The Seawolves only with 35 seconds left to go on the man advantage. Got to try to make something happen. Oh! And a little advised play there by Wilms, trying to get it to Schurting, trying to one-hand it. Took some serious seconds off that power play. This is Hall coming in. He closes up, back to the point. Over to Dozaldi, who misses it and holds it. Now it's to Underhill, back to the point to Schurting, keeps it in. He'll just throw it to the net, and it's deflected to the corner. Down to 8 seconds to go in the man advantage. Down to 5. Picked up by Underhill. Underhill, what's he doing? Holding on to the puck. Back to Cartwright. Fires it to the net, and it just goes into the corner. Lasalle throws it back behind the net over Underhill's stick.
Yeah, this puck is taking some funky bounces in the corner as the ice gets more and more cut up late in the period.
Schurting tries to keep it in. He bangs it, and it's back out into the neutral zone. Picked back up by Schurting. Over to Lazzoli. Lazzoli wants the puck. He's coming in on his off wing. Drop pass, try to get it to Underhill. Back in the net. Offside. Schurting was just outside the zone. And the Seawolves trying to bring some pressure. We're down to 5:31 left to go. in the third period. We got a 4-3 game. The Seawolves inching back into this game, down 4-1.
They're scratching and clawing their way back, and they feel they can do this. This is a team that hasn't quit.
And that's something that Coach Garofalo said earlier tonight when we had our interview with him. He loved the tenacity of this team, the fight on this team, you know. And it's just he didn't think what you saw was going to last too much longer, but they just needed a couple of breaks.
And once they finally start getting their breaks, they get the confidence up, and then they start to put Adrian back on their heels a little bit.
Down right wing is Johnson. Johnson coming in, fires off of Wilms. DeFeo. Stonybrook was able to get the puck out to the neutral zone. Now it's back into the neutral zone. The Seawolves control. Picked up by DeFeo. Coming in, trying to make a move. And not able to get around Alden. And this puck is skipped past. Bishop defending. Kasha on his man. Backhanded into the corner. Schwier. Baudet with the puck. Back down low to Schwier. Bishop on Schwier. Knocks him down. Satola back there. Could not get to the loose puck. Back behind. There's a penalty going to be called.
They're going to call it on Bishop.
It's a bad call. It's not a... Bishop put his stick on it. Yeah, it's not what I would call a cross check. But nonetheless, it's a bad penalty to take with 4:07 left to go. You can't take a penalty. You cannot.
Yeah, can we take a look at the replay on that?
Right now, you're down. Now you got to hope your team can get something on the shorthanded side too.
Yeah, they need to kill this penalty. They cannot give up a goal here because that would be an absolute backbreaker.
Faceoff will be in the Stony Brook zone to the left of Wilms. Crockett, Schurting, and Gervaisi. Crockett won the draw, got it to Schurting. Back to the point. Deflection. Attempt was missed. Back to the point to Alden for Adrian. Down on low. Cartwright trying to get it out. Oh, not able to get it out. McLean controls the puck. Picked up by Gervaisi again. Had plenty of chances to get this puck out of the zone and could not.
They've missed on three opportunities to clear the puck out.
Yeah.
So those are precious seconds that they don't get back and that Adrian still has with the puck in the offensive zone.
Good block by Crockett again. Crockett's done a great job blocking those shots.
He's blocked like three or four on the last several penalty kills.
And here's an opportunity for Gervaisi. Gervaisi coming in one on two, but he's going to dump in and go for a change. We're down to 3:15 to go in the game. 1:05 left to go in the man advantage for Adrian. Coming down right wing, Alden drops off. Pass deflection. It was picked off by the Stony Brook defenseman. Good play by Kasha. Come on. Here's Lozaldi coming in on a potential breakaway. Lozaldi's in. He shoots. Oh, glove save. And it goes high into the netting.
Good chance there by Lozaldi. Had a big chance to tie the game as he was coming off wing and he was trying to go high glove.
Caught.
So we're going to watch it here. Here he comes and he sees Peters coming, so he just takes a quick shot. He was going for the glove and Rodebush just shoves it away.
Caught the defense napping there a little bit, which, you know, could potentially happen in a game like this. This is all on the draw for the Seawolves. Down to 41 seconds left to go in the man advantage for Adrian. Back to the neutral zone. This is McKay. McKay with Taracci. Defended by Kasha. McKay on the boards. Back up to the point. Hostler. Shot over the top of, actually hit with Wilms' glove and over the top of the net. Back to the point. Shot. Oh, looking for the backdoor chance. Down to the last 2 seconds. All even up. Now we're down to 2:05 left to go. Oh, over the top of the net, over the top of Gloom's glove. Seawolves have to get their D off. This is Underhill. Off the wall to DeFeo. Underhill with the puck. Back behind the net to DeFeo. He's got Satola in front. Back to the point to Cartwright. Over to Schoening. One-time shot. And it didn't get all the way to the net. Yeah, Schoening comes all the way in.
Good block by DeRoshi.
Schoening keeps it in with his glove. Trying to keep it in. He's got it. Throws it to the net. He had time. No desperation at this point. Just make sure you get the pucks to the net. That's what you want to do. Back to the point to Schoening. Wrist shot. Glove saved through the screen by Radebush.
And now we're going to see, now that we're down under a minute 20, Wilms is getting...
Seawolves are going to call a timeout right now, and then we'll pull Wilms. And the Seawolves will try to see what they can do to get this game knotted up.
This is a big turning point here. Now we're down in the last little bit.
We have a penalty being called here right now. And it'll be a penalty called on number 5, Sakharopoulos. No, actually it's, number 5.
Yeah, Sakharopoulos.
Sakharopoulos will sit for 2 minutes now for the rest of the game, actually.
Hey, man, what a name.
And this is going to be interesting now because the Seawolves will have a two-man advantage.
Man, this is big here for the Seawolves. 6-on-4 for pretty much the rest of the game.
Right.
They need to pepper Radebush with shots. Get those rebounds. Because we've seen him give up some more second chances in the third period. So get that puck to the net. Don't let him jump on the puck. There should be two players sitting right in front of them.
Yep, they should have two players in front.
And at this point, you want to maybe have, because you want to have that, you want to have the line of Underhill, Lizaldi, and Hall.
You're going to have DeWart, you're going to have Rakus, you're going to have McKinnon, and number 19. Is Polishek out there defending. That's probably the one of their top four.
And right now what the Seals are going to do for the power play, they're going to play 4 forwards, 1 defenseman. So it's going to be the Hall, Lizaldi, the Underhill line with Satola.
They didn't pull Wilms yet. Shot. Oh, down low, deflected to the corner. And right now, Schoening's shot is knocked down by in front by Polishek. And Schoening sent to the ice. Nice move by Hall. Spin move. Shot. No, did not get through all the way down. Wilms, come out and get the puck. I guess they're not going to pull Wilms. I don't understand why they're not pulling the goalie. But, yep. All right, this is Satola. And he loses possession. Now Wilms looks like he's coming. Might be a little too late, though. Yeah, all right. Wilms is to the bench. Extra skater on. Down to the last 24. Still plenty of time here for the Seawolves to get something going. Back to Slazali. Back to the point. Schoening runs. He fires. Rebounds loose. Schoening again. Sends it. Off the wall. 12 seconds to go. Shot. Didn't get through. Back to the point. It's out. And that'll do it, guys, because
they don't have enough time to get back onside.
That'll do it. That'll be the game. Oh, there's a two-hander right at the end there. All right, folks, we got a final in this game, but it's not over yet. These guys are still going at it on the ice as Adrian wins it 4-3, but the Stony Brook Seawolves came back from a 4-1 deficit and setting up for tomorrow's game. Tomorrow's game will be a very interesting game.
Yeah, tomorrow's going to be a really slug it out, drag it out, and it's going to be a bit of a slugfest.
Yeah, I think tomorrow the Seawolves will have a different attitude about the game than they did today. And first time seeing each other on the ice, it's always an interesting scenario, but. There's no doubt the Adrian team came in tonight very pumped up, very ready to play.
Yeah, they came out here and they took home ice away from the Seawolves. They jumped out to an early lead. And Stony Brook had to fight their way back and came about that close.
And the teams will shake hands, as they is customary at the end of these games. No matter how hard they battle, it is an emotional game. We all know that. And tomorrow they'll get to do it again. So, anyway, we've got a 4-3 game. Adrian victorious tonight. Seawolves will come back tomorrow. 37 shots for Adrian, 36 for the Seawolves. And what do we have in scoring in that last period?
So the last period, there were two goals scored, both by Stony Brook. The first one from Tyler Underhill, his 17th, from JT Hall and Justin Lizaldi. And then about 2 minutes later on the power play, JT Hall scored his 12th, his second of the game, from Underhill. It's because the play from Underhill, that Underhill scored on, was that perfect tic-tac-toe play that they like so much.
All right. Okay, folks, we're going to be back here again tomorrow. We'll probably get pregame around 11:30. Hopefully we'll have some better internet. Again, this is not our fault, but you're watching Seawolves Hockey Live. We appreciate you tuning in. On behalf of Andy Seacoff, Trevor Mignani, this is Andy Mignani signing off, and we'll see you tomorrow.